What's up, guys? This week's book is The Diet Myth by Tim Spector. This is an amazing book, really changed my thinking about my diet. I've read this once before, but this was a good reread. And the idea of this book is, of course, it's bust some diet myths, and I like how he talks about diet. It's like all of these other authors seem to like just teach to run away from food, like don't eat any grains, don't eat any gluten, don't eat any dairy or something like that. But this book is more about like eating a variety of foods, because it's good for the microbiome to have like that kind of different foods. And he talks a lot about and seems to be very fascinated by the microbiome and different bacteria in food and stuff and how they affect our bodies. So very interesting book. Here are my favorite 5 takeaways from this book. And by the way, if you want to order this book, the link is right below this video. You can order this book from bookdepository.com. So first idea from this is that counting calories is not enough, because well, obviously, like if you eat 2000 calories a day, it's not the same thing if you eat it from fresh, like organic foods, instead of like 2000 calories of junk food or fast food. So it's just not equal. And then in addition to that, we also have very different like inheritance, and we are all very different, and we react to foods very differently. Even like identical twins are not the same. They like react very differently to foods and kind of like gain much more weight than the other identical twin, because of just like genes and stuff like that. So it's not enough to just like count calories. And now next idea is that how easy you find exercise is genetic as well. That's an interesting point. Note it down. That so for some people exercise actually takes more willpower. It's harder because of genes. So you might have inherited like genes from your parents or grandparents. If they made if they were like athletes or something, then it's easier for you to exercise. For some people it is harder to exercise, but I don't think that's a good enough excuse to not like exercise still. But very fascinating note. But yeah, third is that it's actually good to eat like cheese and yogurt, because they have different kind of bacteria in them. And but of course, like the quality matters a lot here. You cannot just like buy like any kind of cheese or yogurt, but like he especially recommends like French cheeses, like those really like that are full of bacteria, and like this kind of real French cheeses. And then also yogurt that is like very like good quality yogurt, and not like that low fat kind of stuff, but like real yogurt. Then next, that olive oil is also a really good oil. Compared to other oils, it's much better because it's from the whole plant. It's not from the seed, like some other weird oils that are made from the seeds with like chemicals or solvents. So and just in general, like this book also recommends a lot like the Mediterranean diet. So like lots of like those cheese and olive oil, and it even like recommends some kind of alcohol like wine. I don't actually myself drink any alcohol, but some kind of like wine or something can be just fine. And then finally, idea 5 is that processed foods are bad because a lot of salt, sugar and fat has been added to them. And the reason is that they try to make them last longer in the shelves. So like in America, for example, there is very hard like to preserve those foods because the distribution is so big, like if you go countrywide and distribute everywhere. And so they just add a lot of salt, sugar and fat. Of course, they also think about how to optimize like that tastiness, so that people get hooked on the food and buy more of it. But also if it lasts longer, they can sell more of that product. So that's like, that's why processed foods are really bad, because they are really high in like sugar and fat and salt, and not any like good kind of fat really anyway, but like trans fats and weird fats like that. But those are my favorite 5 takeaways from this book. Thanks so much for watching. Make sure to like this video and subscribe, and I'll see you in the next one.